Every good model in Power BI starts with a calendar dimension. Just switch here to the modeling tab and we will create a new table. There's a function called calendar, which actually builds a list of the dates. Let's build a calendar from the 1st of January, like that, to 2018. So that's the end of my data. It's like 2018, end of 2018, enter, and this then will return a simple column called the date. That's exactly what we already have in our sales table, right? But what, why I'm doing this is now that I have this column, I can add new columns, all right? So I just clicked new column, and now I can add my own time. The first one we'll just call the year, and we'll just extract the year from the date. The function year will extract this for me, and I'll just refer to my date field here, and this simply returns the year. Use the format function, which actually can format the date to get the year. You just type 4Y letters, and now this has returned again the year, but this time it's text. Now we'll add another column, we'll call it the month, right? And again, we'll use the format formula, format the date. So this is how you can now build your custom columns, which you will use in your report. Let's add the quarter. This returns the number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, just the numbers. If you want to have like Q1, Q2, Q3, I would add the letter Q in front of the number. And you do that by concatenating. So you can just type in the text Q and then join this with the AND operator together with the number. Enter and you get the Q1. I'll just show you an alternative way in DAX how to do this. There's a function called add columns, which can actually add all the columns within this function. And now this has built the whole calendar table with all the columns and so on. And you can simply, you know, simply change here. How do you want your years to look like? The calendar auto is a version of the calendar function, which actually automatically searches for the dates in your database and will just automatically find the minimum, maximum date and just build everything automatically. Let's go back to my model. I have added my calendar dimension. So I have a new dimension, but it's not linked. It's not related to my data. So you need to click here on the date field and just link this, make a relationship to the sales table. So the date field here, the date field here. And while I'm doing this, I will actually hide this field, because from now on, we will not use it anymore in the report. We'll just use the calendar dimension. Instead of using the date field from your sales table and so on, you're using the calendar dimension, right? And now you're much more flexible. So you can just say, all right, I want to see, you know, my sales by year. The sort order is not okay. You need to switch to your to your field that you want to sort by, and now sort ascending will sort the years correctly, right? If you do this for the month, there's another caveat here. So if you have a monthly view, all right, you need to just sort by the month and you sort ascending. So this is just an alphabetical sort order. So you need to tell Power BI how to sort the month. You click on your month. So these are my month labels. And now you go here to sort by column. You open this and now you'll find your month number, which is also one column in my calendar. And I will say, all right, this month is now sorted by the month number. All right, so this is the way how you actually get your month sorted in Power BI. So these are absolute pure bare necessities in Power BI.